Jay did his thing. The hook is crazy. Everything's crazy. So I just did, you know, boom, ba boom, 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 ba boom, ba boom, ba boom, 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 ta 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 ba boom, ba boom, 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 ba boom, ba boom, ba boom, 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 ba 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 boom, ba boom, for like 6 minutes. Without, you know, it wasn't programmed. I just did it live, hitting the, you know, hitting drum pads. What up, boo? Just keep me laced in the illest snakes. Bank rolls is all back rubs in the French tub. Smacking into the ass wife. Yeah, I was someone you could almost. I don't remember the days you was dead broke. But now you're styling. I raised you, basically made you into a dumb. Wait. But now you're styling. I raised you, basically made you into a dumb. On the way it went on and on. You know the money is all that. That's why I get baguettes, 5 carats and all that. From Doe Shake up on it and on. Spindle, I'm ringing bells. That's not something that a 15-year-old should know about. A 15-year-old should not be knowing about commissary and riding shotgun and putting the gun in a Chanel bag. Like, that was just unheard of. So I think it was the shock value when I came out and then I was spitting, like, you know, it was just, it was crazy because JJ just did it so smooth. From the village to the valley, time to kill it on the leash. No question, I have more black chicks between my sheets than exes. They say sex is a weapon, so when I shoot, meet your death in less than 8 seconds. Still pounding in my afterlife, laughing, my head is tight. I really was saying these type of things to connect with my friends and connect with the guys who live the same life that I live. Yo, now how we get this stuff played? But as I was recording this album, I was really just trying to impress the people that go through that, the same thing I was going through.
This was at a time when every guy in Brooklyn were driving Sterlings and Cressidas, and that was the hottest car at the time in Brooklyn. And here comes Jay with the white Lexus GS, the rims. That GS was so important, and it almost struggled with us. We were Bonnie and Clyde, and I was just Bonnie riding with him along for the ride. That era of 1995, 1996 symbolizes just our struggle.
When people say, why rappers always talk about cars and Yuri and things like that, those are small wins. Those small wins are really like, you've made it somewhere. You gotta realize where we're coming from, first of all. That these things are big things to us. It signifies some type of success, that you're heading in the right type of direction. So you celebrate it. Maybe a little too much, but you do celebrate these things because these things are big wins for you. And you don't have so many wins. And you've been on the quest to get this the whole time by any means necessary. The thing about Reasonable Doubt, the album cover, it looks like it's a, you know, about a mafioso or Godfather type person, but it's really not. It's really about situations that take place in our area, in urban environments. All those situations and every single thing that's inside this album takes place in our hood. But when further, it was the emotions of these young guys going through this, which I don't believe, you know, had been done before.
Never.
It's the emotion, real emotion, though.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Hey, yo, we patting down my ass from Sugar Hill to the Shark Bar. All MSD in the mark car. We got the bad ass gasping for air and aspirin. Searching for aspirin when I assin'. We swing, you cling, we do our thing and bring. Sling and ding-a-ling from Best Stop, Brooklyn to Beijing. East Coast host is high, still colossal. Money flaring like nostrils from drug dealing impossible. Son, Al Pacino down and Nino Brown. Me, J. and Primo. Got a soda across the board like Pacino. Teflon, make sure your jammy is full. This classic hip-hop right here. We've been doing this since the neighborhood. Before there was record deals in place, we was in the neighborhood in little houses, sweating, just going at it all day, sharpening our skills with each other, like a basketball player. Like, you practice with your friends on the court, and you play one-on-one games against them.
I play a beat on the table, he rhyme, he passes it to me, and back and forth all the time. We want our craft like this, like. And our whole goal is to rhyme perfect every time, perfection.
We was all trying to be better than each other, friendly competition.
It was a war. It was a war in the studio. Like, your brother's going in there and you watching them put it down, and you like, man, I gotta put it down. Like, I can't be looking crazy, you know, because we were so lyrical. Let me backtrack. They were so lyrical. It was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, I gotta step up, man. Al Pacino down and Nino Brown. Me, Jay, and Primo got
a soda across the board like Pacino. Teflon, make sure your jammy is full. Saw us money, It's always, you know, chin up, chest out. So we were really feeling ourselves, and Bring It On was kind of an anthem song of like, this is us, and, you know, basically, if I may use a profanity, I don't know, you know, y'all can't with us.
We all challenged each other, really.
Still shopping, still.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, when you hear, you know, Jazz going in and saying something crazy, and you like, man, how can you say anything, you know, to top that?
Absence of malice in my palace. Call cousin out Dallas. Finger with the callus. Tip scales for mail to keep these is off balance.
Absence of malice in my palace. Call cousin out Dallas. Bite a finger with the callus. Tip scales for mail to keep these is off balance. Your frequency.
Then, you know, Jay going there and he just, you know, like, I'm looking for the, you know, the nearest subway, man, because I know I can't top that.
I gotta keep my steam in, wanna try to hem my long jeans. Uptown fiend for Jay-Z to appear on the scene.
And you know, we pushed each other, you know, and, well, they pushed me pretty much. Yeah.
Jay-Z doesn't write much down. He'll listen to the beat. He goes through these weird faces he does, like, he gets weird, you know what I mean? And you see, like, this morph from Sean Carter to Jay-Z. He gets crazy, and just watching him, and then he just sits there. He does this a lot. All right, I'm ready.
Now it's unstoppable cheese. Said we was garbage, so it's in my college.
Cheese knowledge amazing. Scholars when we coin phrases for dollars. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
coin phrases for dollars.
Like, wait, I need that line. Street knowledge amazes the scholars when we coin phrases for dollars. That says everything. It says it all right there. That's the mentality, the attitude, and it's mixed with the metaphors. Growing up as we grew up, you feel trapped, like you feel like your back's against the wall, you know. And like I said, it was just humanizing, you know, the hustler.
He brought angst and existentialism to the street, you know, in terms of I'm a hustler on the outside, you know, I'm ice cold, but inside I shouldn't be doing this. I'm killing people. I'm killing myself. There's stress. That's what he says on Regrets, you know.
So that all from dope to OPM and third person, I don't want to see him. So I'm rehearsing with my people how to GM from a remote location in the VM.
On songs like Regrets, where he's saying, you know, I sold it all from dope to OPM and third person, I don't want to see them. You know what I mean? He's disgusted with what he's doing, but he has to. And that's why a song like Regrets is probably one of the hottest songs he's ever done in his career, because of the realism.
When I was young, you would hold me, told me I was the best. Anything in this world I want, I could possess. All that made me want is all that I could get. In order to survive, gotta learn to live with regrets. And the only way I was gonna, well, for me, that I seen at the time, was the only way I was gonna achieve these things was doing illegal activity. There was no other way out.
Find myself reminiscing. Remember this one when he was saying he was crazy nice with his son. I miss him. I'm slipping. He's slipping through memories. He's there to kill all my suicidal tendencies in heaven, looking over me, or in hell, keeping it cozy. I'm coming like on these streets and what it's supposed to be. Remember Newton, mutual friend with me and him feuding.
It's like survival of the fittest. You take that mentality, you've accepted all that comes with this. You know, you might get caught, you have to accept that. You can't tell on anyone. You've accepted that, you put yourself in harm's way. You've accepted that. You've accepted that there's gonna be some casualties of war. You've accepted that, you know? So you know you're gonna regret these situations and you gotta learn to live with it.
But my hustle's going too well to hit him. You was right, I just want you to be miserable with him. Anyway, I ain't trying to hear it. I think I'm cursed this whole verse. I've been talking to your spirit a little too much. This is the number one rule for your set. In order to survive, gotta learn to live with regrets.
He's presenting the song as Jay-Z, but he's letting you into Sean Carter, showing you a glimpse of who this person really is, you know? And that's the voice of our generation.
That may have been the closest I've come to the two, right? Between Sean Carter and Jay-Z, it may have been the closest I've come.
He gave a voice to the guys who hustled, who killed, who robbed, and who sold drugs. It was like, you know, I'm caught up in this. I know I got to do it. I got to eat, but at what cost? There's a price to this. He always gave the consequence, the other side to, you know, the road to the riches.
I'm seeing the American dream right here in front of my eyes. Jay-Z, Rockefeller Records, go from something like this to the biggest thing in not only hip-hop, but entertainment and sports and anything you name. He's got his hand in. That's a real hustler. That's what he is.
We had the mentality that we had in the streets of hustling and, you know, re-ing up and putting it back into the business. We took that mentality and adapted it and applied it in the music business, and, you know, it worked out for us.
But you still always remember your first album. It's like your first child, yeah. And that's what it is. It's like you're giving birth, you know.
But this thing is your whole life, everything put into this album.
You could roll the credits up with that now, you know what I mean? It's a happy ending.